Well, welcome back. It is another gray day in Oregon, and it's a bit drippy right now underneath some big old fir trees. Today is day 9 of April, so day 9 of me painting outside every day for the month of April, and it happens to be Easter right now. So I kind of planned ahead, and I made this small portion in my sketchbook to work on today so that I don't have to spend a lot of time working on my painting. So stay tuned, and let's see what I create. Okay, so yesterday I painted this guy. Did a page and like a third, more or less, maybe a quarter. So I only have this much to work on today. Like I mentioned earlier, I planned this ahead because today is Easter and I don't want to spend too much time painting. So I am sitting on my parents' porch and I see a little grouping of daffodils that I think I'm going to sketch out. Some bright yellow daffodils could be a good juxtaposition to this very gray landscape. Okay, here are my little daffodils. I already spritzed my gouache. Today I'm using my medium brush, size 8, my travel brushes, and I'm gonna do lots of yellows. So I need to get rid of these colors. So I am using my medium size brush today. It's a size 8. If you are interested in seeing the exact same brushes that I use in this video, make sure to check the description of this video. I do have them listed on my Amazon storefront. So time to mix colors. So yellow is a very, I would call it a timid color. So you have to be really careful about how you do things. So first I make some greens. I might just treat these kind of like this one, kind of like a watercolor painting, in the sense that I'm not gonna do the whole background. Now, as this dries, I'm going to work on all my yellows. I definitely don't want any of my yellows to run into these greens. Can you see the differences in the yellow? So this is an azo yellow with some titanium white, and this is a lemon yellow with titanium white. Can you see the difference? Like, this is definitely more cooler and this is warmer. And looking at my daffodils, these daffodils pretty much have the same color, but looking at them, it appears the outside area is slightly more pale. So I'm just going to block in with this yellow right now. And I'm blocking in with this lemon yellow and the titanium white for the exterior petals. And the green is still wet, so it's really getting picked up when I'm blocking in these petal shapes. That's okay because gouache is opaque, and so I can cover that up. Okay, I took a little break to let it all dry. It's pretty well dry right now, except for a little bit right there, it looks like. So let's go through and grab some more titanium white. My lemon yellow. a lighter shade. Just really look into where, bring in the light color. So I'm just working on blocking off some of the lightest colors of, I don't know the anatomy of daffodils, so just the petals that are on the outside. I think I'll have to do this in a couple layers because the green is still working its way forward. I mean, yellow is the color. Yellow as a color is very naturally, I would call it timid. It's easily overpowered. And so I'm not really surprised that it's easy to see the green underneath everything. So I'm gonna work on mixing some of the yellows. So there's like a darker yellow on the inside. And instead of mixing black with it, which would make it kind of green, I'm gonna mix my yellow ochre color, titanium yellow ochre. Use that guy. Kind of make more of an orange shadow, make it more a vibrant shadow. Not all shadows are just the color with black or gray added to it. And I'm just utilizing the shape of my paintbrush to get some of the edge work. All right, I got out my little detail brush, which is a size 4, and I'm gonna work on some of the details. I'm gonna get another dark color going, something just a little bit darker, getting my titanium gold ochre from Schmeeka, and I'm going to add a hint of my burnt sienna, And I'm really looking at the flowers to see where this color is. Really have to squint hard, like their shadow here, but it's really honestly not a warm shadow, it's a cool shadow, so I'll come back to that part. I am sitting on the front porch of my parents because we're here for Easter. And here, my daughter giggling and playing inside. So I bet you could probably hear her too in the background. I kind of like that shadows. It helps pull back the petals a little bit without being like too much on the green side. like color mixing, it's a lot of work. You don't realize it until you're in the thick of it too. It's like, oh man. Felt like overdoing it too. It's like, I can see why they teach classes in color theory. Because it's kind of like a science, a math. Really slowing down to observe the color. Like, I picked this more or less simple subject because I didn't want to spend a lot of time painting, but you know, sometimes the simple ones can really get you because the color is more complex than you anticipated. Trying to smooth out some of my brush strokes. She is trying to open the front door to get to me, apparently. Or at least to get outside. Because outside... Oh no, my paintbrush fell apart. There we go. Because outside is a very fun place to be. Especially out on a farm. I hear turkeys and great blue herons. Yes, there are wild turkeys here. And they're going gobble gobble right now, down close to the road. Okay, I think this is dry enough I can really work in my titanium white to work up some highlights. Kind of get rid of this green look. thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a little like. And if you want to see more videos like this, especially my Plein April series of where I go outside every day the month of April of 2023 and do a little plein air painting, make sure to subscribe to my channel. So today was day 9. It's Easter Sunday. I did that cute little daffodil painting, and now I'm going to go back inside and hang out with my family. So thank you again for watching. I hope this has inspired you, and I will see you in the next video.